The last thing a lot of parents and family members ask is, what happens after surgery? So in many times, the scariest part of the treatment is the surgery itself. Going through the surgery, recovering, especially in the first day or two after, that's really when there's the greatest risk of having blood pressure shifts or a stroke from the surgery. And while that risk never goes away, it gets less and less each day further out the child gets from surgery. Typically, kids will go home 3 to 5 days after surgery. So if the surgery's on a Wednesday, we check on them each day in the hospital, and usually they get home over the weekend. Again, typically a day or two in Boston and then back home right thereafter. Kids can go back to school at any time. Usually we say to think about taking about a week off of school or so. We do restrict physical education, gym, for several weeks, but they can go outside, go for walks, get pizza, hang out with their friends. They should be eating and drinking normally and walking around, going to school in a week or so. So that's pretty much what happens after. We do a checkup usually at 1 month, see how the child's doing and start resuming activities. And usually within several weeks to a couple of months after surgery, somewhere between 8 and 12 weeks, we let them do pretty much anything. We do try to restrict things like tackle football, boxing, really hard hits to the head. But most kids live full and normal lives. We check an MRI at 6 months, and then we get either an MRI or an angiogram at 1 year. And then once a year for 5 years, we get an MRI, and then every 2 to 3 years thereafter. We've published our series here with over 20 years of follow-up, and these kids do really well. Despite being a very scary disease, these kids grow up, they play sports, they have kids of their own, they get graduate degrees. One of my patients ran a marathon shortly after, something even I can't do. So while every child is different, and there are certainly kids that have tough outcomes, by and large, the expectation is these children go on to live full and wonderful lives. And we've shown that with our research here over decades and decades. So at the end of the day, while this is a scary diagnosis, it's one for which we have great treatments. We have a very wonderful multidisciplinary team here at Children's, and we're very invested in trying to do our best to take care of these children and also really advance the field both in the operating room and in the laboratory going forward. As always, we're here to help. We're doctors and family members first. And please call us, email us, or reach out to us at any time. And we're here to help as you progress through your journey in moyamoya. Hope these have been helpful little educational tools for you.